psychologist for 30 years. My wife was as well. So we were two psychologists who met 21 years ago. And we hit it off pretty well and decided to have a life together. Spent a lot of time traveling. We travel 3 to 4 months out of the year. It was really quite a delightful time. So then the Parkinson's came along and sort of interrupted things for a bit. Parkinson's, most people don't know much about it. I have quite a litany of symptoms that I have been afflicted with, and really strange ones. So it's a very hard diagnosis to arrive at, because they're looking at only certain things, you know, tremor and balance and gait. A lot of people think, oh, that's the shaking disease, you know, you get the shakes. But I wasn't manifesting any of those. Mine is really primarily dysautonomic, which means a dysregulation of the autonomic nervous system. It's a rough diagnosis to get at first. Most people think, oh, my life is over, so they sit down and sit in a chair and wait to die, basically. That's very common. They get depressed. I wasn't about to do that, obviously. I have a lot to live for and a wonderful life. I wanted to keep it going.
I first met Charles in 2018, and at that point, he'd already had Parkinson's for about 12 years. He'd already been taking levodopa, which is the most typical treatment we use for Parkinson's disease. And though it had helped him for his tremor, mobility, and speech, he was unable to tolerate it due to his restless legs syndrome.
You cannot sleep at all. I mean, it's terrible. Kicking really quite strongly, up to 3 times a minute for hours on end in the middle of the night. Sleep is completely disrupted. Then it gets worse and worse and worse. I needed something to help me feel like myself again.
We started talking about deep brain stimulation surgery in 2019. I asked him to see my colleague, Dr. Langevin, for a consultation.
Some patients will have a combination of conditions that makes the treatment challenging because the medication that would help one condition may make the symptoms of the other one worse. So in those cases, then it's nice to have a therapy to augment the treatment without using meds. The DBS is continuously on in the background doing its job, and it never goes off. And so what it does, it's acting a little bit as an equalizer where it brings you into good control of symptoms and it keeps you there throughout the day.
He underwent deep brain stimulation or DBS surgery in August of 2020. He noticed significant improvement in his mobility, in his posture, in his voice, less tremor. His mood had been lifted and he was feeling cognitively clearer. We did have to make some adjustments over the first few months because he was actually feeling a little too energized. But by the beginning of 2021, he was pretty settled with the programming that he's been on and not needing any levodopa.
DBS is a game changer. It is a lifesaver. It brings you to functioning much as you once did.
One of the things that's really key about Charles and Mary is their dedication and commitment to exercise and also other pursuits in addition, like painting and, you know, enjoying the arts. That's been really, really helpful for him and for many of my patients. He's been doing physical therapy in a very dedicated manner, and we've often seen how important that is for patients with Parkinson's.
The main credit I give when people say, hey, you're doing so great with this, what's your secret, you know? Well, my first secret is this place, Dr. Langevin and Dr. Petrosian. Every single person that I run into here is really stellar. Just examples of the way it should be done. I can do all kinds of things that people with Parkinson's can't do. And I can do all kinds of things that I couldn't do before deep brain stimulation. I felt vulnerable, I felt afraid of everything. Stairs started to scare me. I started to be unsure of my footing. Now, I can walk anywhere, I'm not afraid of stairs, I'm not afraid of social interactions, I'm not afraid of anything anymore. I'm back, I'm finally back. It's quite touching just to think of it, where I was and where I am now.